Hi friends, I am so excited today because I am finally taking you on a house tour. This is long awaited, and if you've ever moved into a house, you know making a house a home is a labor of love. We have been in this place for over a year now, but I finally feel like we are settled and I'm ready to show it off. Follow along as I give you some of my tips and tricks for how I made our tiny little 1940s beach bungalow into a cozy home. This is the first room that you walk into, which is our living room. And the first thing that you'll notice, obviously, is this massive couch. We got this couch from Living Spaces. We custom ordered it, and it took over 9 weeks to get here. We absolutely love it. The color is oatmeal, and there's this kind of gritty texture, so we have found that it wears super well. It's also kind of known as the cloud lookalike. We are just obsessed. The second piece that I just absolutely love in this room is this massive coffee table. This coffee table is from a brand called Our House. It's kind of like a faux wood. We absolutely love it. It is super jumbo. So when we first got it, we actually thought it was gonna be a little too big for the space, but we are big people. Another thing that you'll see on a lot of my tables are coffee table books. This one is actually from my sister-in-law, Sid. So every time I see it, I think of her. I absolutely love the colors. It's just fun, bright, sunshiny. Surf shacks I love. So I switch these out whenever I find another one that I love, and I'll kind of rotate them through. This is just our little sunshiny corner. So we have our blanket basket, which this is an amazing find. This is from World Market. I love it. It's super jumbo. It's hard to find super big blanket baskets, but this one is like definitely an XL. Love this bright, fun little plant. This was actually in Brandon's old place. We have been watering this, and it is just thriving in this little corner. It's growing nonstop, sprouting leaves every other week. I potted it in this cute little pot that I actually got from Home Goods, and we put little white rocks in there. And then tucked away in this corner, we just have this beautiful, simple white and gold lamp. I also got this at Home Goods, and we placed it on this funky little tribal themed stump. I call it my stump, and I love it. It's just tucked away in the corner. You can't really see it, but it's just something fun, and it elevates the lamp a little bit onto this side. So this is kind of our little TV console. One of the things you'll first notice is this book that I have open with a crystal on it. So this is a tip from my mom. She always has books open on beautiful pages. This is one of the Surf Shacks edition, and the front cover got wrecked by one of my candles. So I was like, oh, this is perfect. There's so many beautiful images in here. So I switch the image every few weeks. My mom does this, so this makes me think of her, and I just love it because it's a way to kind of change the vibe every few weeks as you switch the photos. And then these are some of our books that we just have on display. Fun ones just to grab and read or go through when you have guests. And I also just love the fun little colors down here. These are some handmade wooden coasters from a friend, and just a little tribal vase that sometimes I'll put flowers in. My salt rock lamp, which I feel like everyone has one by now. They're so fun in the evening, such a nice glow. Our Marshall speaker, which I use a lot. I love it. We have the little dongle. I think they're called. And this I just keep out because sometimes, you know, when I have flowers, I'll put flowers in there as well. So that's kind of fun. And then over here, we have our fiddle that's also growing like crazy. We have it potted in a white pot with some white stones on top. Moving over here, this piece of art was such a find. I found this at Home Goods as well. I'm obsessed with it. So I love the soft pink. It's a nice pop of color. The gold foil leaf is beautiful. It reflects off the sun when the sun shines in from the windows. It came pre-framed in this really gorgeous, just kind of simple wooden frame. So this was a great find. And then this lamp tucked away in the corner is also a good find. We actually have two. It's from World Market. We love it because of the small base. So this is perfect for small spaces because you can just tuck it away and it kind of disappears with the rest of the room. But like I said, we love it. It gives off a really nice light. And moving over here, our floor length mirror, which this took me so long to find. I actually found this on an app called OfferUp. There was a hair salon that had just opened before COVID, and they bought these mirrors for the salon from Ethan Allen. They were over $3,000 each, and I actually got this for $200. So this is definitely a steal. It's just a great piece. We love it because I believe it's about 7 feet tall, and I really wanted one that was over a certain height just so that it looked, you know, substantial on this wall. I feel like this definitely accomplished it. The last thing that I'll point out is this rug. Finding a rug for this room was definitely a feat because we didn't want to take away from the beautiful natural light, but we got this rug at this warehouse called I think Rugs Plus in Newport. It's great. It wears really well. It's just kind of like a soft blue and a cream. On to our den. So this is what some would consider a bonus room, and we have kind of turned it into a little wellness center, gym center, home office center, and we love this room. We use it a lot. So it's kind of just like a catch-all storage space in a sense, but we wanted to make it vibey. So as you can see in this little corner, it's kind of like the little sauna station. So we have a bench where you can put your robe on or take your slippers off. I found this super cute basket from Home Goods, so I just keep it stuffed with towels when we go in the sauna. And then we have another one of our favorite lamps stuffed in the corner. As you can tell, the little base just fits perfectly in there, but it totally lights up this space in the evening. And then just a fun little macrame piece from World Market right there. This bench I actually love. It's from Target, Opal Home. It was super cheap, but I love the colors. The wood matches the floor, and the rug is from World Market as well, which is just kind of like a cozy textural vibe. And then this plant I've had for so long, it's thriving over here as well. Our plants just love this house. So that's the original pot it came in. I've always wanted to change it, but the terracotta doesn't bug me over here. And then the sauna, which I would definitely say steals the show in this room. So this is our sauna. Brandon uses it every day. I use it probably like once every 2 weeks. And then our art wall, which was also a labor of love. I got all of these prints on Etsy. So I bought them from individual artists and I printed them out at Costco. And the frames are a mix from IKEA, Amazon. And as you can tell, we took the glass out. I kind of like this look. It just feels natural and creative. This table is so stunning. This is kind of what I'm using as my desk area right now. So this table was actually found on Facebook Marketplace. It's all reclaimed wood, it's stunning. And it was actually from a coffee shop in North Hollywood that closed because of COVID, so sad for them, but I totally lucked out. And then this chair I found from a neighbor on next door. And I will say, this chair is actually from West Elm, and it's like, I think $350, and my amazing neighbor gave it to me when I moved in because we moved in right at the beginning of COVID and didn't have any furniture, so this is definitely a win. I absolutely love this chair. I will give a little shout out to my printer stand. I think it's so cute. Everyone else thinks it's ridiculous, but I got it from Home Goods and it's a vibe, so there we go. This lamp I have had for eons. I had this growing up. It followed me to my dorm and it's been in every house since, so. Our beautiful backyard. I have this view from what you could call my office. Grass needs some watering, but what a treat to have a yard like this in the beach city. These are my plants, which I just love. I love when the light shines in here on these plants. I feel like I'm in nature and I love that. This is my little studio corner. I think this is also a skinny mirror, which is not really working right now, but that's okay. And then flipping over to here, this little table I also got from the same neighbor who gave me the chair. It's this little mid-century modern piece, which I like because it kind of just disappears. This tray and beads I got at Home Goods, just kind of a fun decor. I move it around every few weeks. And then this is kind of like my little yoga station, right? So I have my sage and Palo Santo. This rock salt lamp actually changes colors, so super moody when you're sweating. And then this jumbo shell is from my Grammy. I just keep it out, it makes me think of her. All my mats are in this other bin that I got from Home Goods. I wanted one that was not fabric or cloth so that if I rolled up a sweaty mat, I felt like it could air out and dry. These are just our fun little surfboards that we keep in here so that we have easy access to them now that the weather is warming up. So yeah, this is our den. Moving over to the bedrooms and bathroom. This is the master. Pretty small, pretty minimal. So the first thing that you might notice is this bench. This is actually the bench that came with the reclaimed wood table, and I just threw a little fur on top to add some texture. This rug is from Wayfair. I've had it for so long, but it's amazing. It's super thin, so you can just honestly throw it in the wash. It's super durable, comfy. Our bed is a Cal King, if anyone's wondering. The piece of art above the bed is also a piece from Etsy, and the frame is from Amazon. One of the things I love on my side of the bed is this cute little rug. I just like waking up and having this warm, fluffy little sheepskin to step on. This table has also followed me from childhood. I had it growing up in my childhood room, and here it is now. This kind of wind chime I found at an estate sale. This lamp, which we also love, is from IKEA, so that was a great find. This surfboard is from my mom's best friend, Isabel. I just love it. It's beat to shit. But I love it. It's such a vibe. It's such a pop of color. It's so fun. Then we have a little plant hanging right there. This dresser we actually got at IKEA. It's not the nicest thing in the world, but it works for a small space. And this mirror I actually found at a Goodwill in college with my roommate, and I've had it ever since. It's just such a solid piece. My mom always hangs necklaces on the corner of mirrors. It's kind of something that I do now too, and I think of my mom every day. This book is from one of my best friends, Haley. It makes me think of her. I love the yellow. This cute little fan I got on Amazon just to kind of bring some white noise and some airflow into the room. Those are Brandon's surfboards. Just to finish off the room, we have this floor to ceiling gold trimmed mirror that I also found at Home Goods. This was such a good find. I wanted a really big, substantial mirror for this back wall. It makes the space bigger. This is our little money tree, which is also thriving. Moving on to the guest room, which we call my room. Oh, I love this room. It has all of my furniture in it. So this is kind of where I get ready. The room is small, but we definitely made it work. So on this back wall, we have this big, beautiful dresser that was actually from Brandon's old place. So we put it in here because it didn't fit in the other room. And I love it. I obviously have a bunch of clothes in it, but it's solid wood. It's super sturdy. It has this mirror that's attached to it, which is super nice. And then over here, you'll see, I have a little crystal grid that I kind of rearrange every few weeks. And I have some of my hats hung right here. This cutie little table is something that my mom actually gifted to me. It has been in the family for quite some time. I think that was an estate sale find too. This rug is from Rugs USA online. It's kind of like a jute rug, but it's a pale, almost like washed cream white. It's super durable. This is a high traffic area. I'm obviously getting ready in here, so I wanted something that I didn't have to worry about. Moving over here, another massive mirror I actually found on Facebook Marketplace from someone who was moving down the street. So this is it's a great piece. I'm not a huge fan of the silver. I've always wanted to paint it, but we'll probably get to that soon. And this bench is something that my mom gifted me. I'm so lucky. She has the best style. She gifts me all of these amazing pieces. So this is another vintage estate sale find. This gorgeous mustard yellow, burnt yellow velvet bench. So I love it. It's great to just set things on when you're getting ready. I'll sit on it when I'm throwing my shoes on. And then pan over to the bed. This is just a collection of pillows that I've acquired throughout the years. I literally swapped two out this morning. Always constantly changing. This I am so proud of. I have always wanted a Pray for Surf sign. I actually made it by hand, so I bought the canvas and the black fabric from a fabric store down the street, and I traced all of these letters. I made stencils, I cut them out, I sewed them on by hand. I love the vibe. I wanted some black in here to kind of tie in the knobs on this end. I tend to gravitate towards like creams and light colors, but I felt like I needed some black just to bring some dimension to the room. So I love it. This vanity, this stool, I'm not even gonna show it. It has just got to go. This sheepskin I love. I found it on Etsy from this woman who hand makes them, I think in Poland. Yeah, I love it. I've ordered a few. I'll show you the other one. This vanity has been with me for years. I found this on the side of the road in Truckee when I was going to college. My mom and I refurbished the entire thing. I painted it white, ended up replacing the knobs with just different ones from Anthropology, as you can tell. My dad added legs, so it's a little higher. You can tell it's like super beat down, but I just love it. It fits perfectly in this corner. It also doubles as a little nightstand, which by the way, this lamp I found at Goodwill. I bought a shade at Target. You can see with the light off, the shade is blue and the stand is cream. So yeah, this is where I get ready. Awesome natural light. Great, feel like I'm getting ready in nature. This little tapestry is just a pop of color. My dad has a thing with suns, so I feel like I've always had a sun in my room. It reminds me of him. So my little perfume tray, which this vintage thing was also gifted to me from my mom. That's my closet, which we won't go into. Trash can. A lot of people know my story with this trash can. Great trash can. I've had it for years. Nothing else needs to be said. It's from IKEA. And yeah, this wraps up my room. This is where I film the rest of my YouTube videos. The lighting's great in here. Good vibes. On to the bathroom. So back in this little hallway, you'll see this cute blue mirror, which is also just a pop of color. This is from my family friends, Chanel, Chloe, Julie. We've done this thing forever where we like swap pieces of furniture. I have this right now and I love it because I think of them every time I walk through this hall, which is literally every day because our house is tiny. So our bathroom is nothing glamorous. I installed this little shelf from Target just to kind of add a little something above the toilet. So we have a little like room spray and candle that I swap out, a little diffuser that my friend Lexi got me. it smells unreal. Little basket with our toilet paper. And then this is literally like very teeny. This is it. So here's another shelf that I installed. I put little hooks down here for our towels. I keep this little acrylic thing filled with Q-tips. This is always switching out whatever face spray I'm using, and then whatever lotion. This is filled with little placards. This is it. This is the bathroom. And we only have one. So coming back through here, this is the kitchen. Kitchen tour is pretty small. This kitchen has the best lighting ever. This is our little dining room table. As you can see, I have another sheepskin here. This rug underneath it is from Urban. I love it just because it's dark, it's neutral, it's basic, it wears really well. I have a little rug pad under it. And then I layered it with another sheepskin from that same woman because I loved the other one. This little bench was a find from HomeGoods. It's super sturdy. It's honestly epic. It fits perfectly at this little table. We have these little wishbone chairs that I believe I got from, I don't even remember now, but they're just white, and we threw a little sheepskin from IKEA on top to make them a little more comfortable. So sometimes we'll take them off. We might take them off for summer. They're a little uncomfortable without the fur. This is my bulletin board, which I'm constantly pinning different things on, like magazine clippings, cards, just kind of always switching up the vibe. As you can see, I have another one of my magazines open with a little crystal on top. Beautiful view out into the yard. This lamp is a stunner. Goodwill, baby. Goodwill. Shade from Target. Love it. Another little plant hanging in the corner. Yeah, this is our kitchen. The only really standout things to point out are my stack of cookbooks, which again, this is constantly changing. And this is just a little margarita mix that one of my friends got me for my birthday. Lexi. I just love having fresh flowers in the house. Usually I have way more, but that one just seems to be lingering, and it's stunning, beautiful. Love it. This is my cutie little Smeg that Sid and Lake got me. I use it every morning. Here, this is just, that's just super satisfying, so I thought I would let you guys experience it. And then I always have little flowers by my soap, so this I'll probably have to switch out and see. It looks like it's getting a little brown. Yeah, that's a thing that my mom does. She always has little flowers everywhere. This is the stove side. So since our kitchen is super small, I have this cutting board from Crate and Barrel on here, which I love. It's just kind of, it adds a little bit of counter space. And then we have this rug, which is from World Market, I think. Again, it's a jute rug, but it's just neutral. It ties into the rest of the kitchen and the rest of the house. It wears super well. Heavy traffic area. And this is another little ceramic bowl from Crate and Barrel. It kind of has this little tie-dye thing. And I usually keep it full of like avocados, bananas, fruits. This last thing is a barn door that goes into our laundry room. But other than that, I think we're done. Thank you guys so much for following along. I've been dying to take you guys into my house and show you all the nooks and crannies. I will link what I can below in the description box. I hope you liked it. If you did, please subscribe so you don't miss the next video. It'll probably be a bikini haul. Hopefully see you guys soon. Bye.